When I was a beginner chip carver, I wanted to stain some of my projects. I asked a famous chip carver what stain they used, and I was basically told it was a secret. So we had to come up with a method of our own for staining. But we're not going to keep our method a secret. First, we use Ipswich Pine by Minwax as a pre-stain. Ipswich Pine is so runny that it has a tendency to stain the surface from underneath. So I stain the surface before I stain the cuts. Periodically, I pause to wipe off the excess from the surface with a paper towel. Here, if we did not sand the end grain perfectly, it would soak into the end grain and become much darker. But with proper sanding, it stays the same color as the rest of the wood. Once I've stained some of the project, I use a paper towel to hold the project so my hand oils do not get on the project and also so my hand does not get stain on it. When I'm finished staining with Ipswich Pine, I then set it aside for at least 24 hours to dry. Here's a mirror that was stained with Ipswich Pine and has been sitting for more than 24 hours. Notice how the color has faded with time. It's now ready to stain with Czar Stain. One of my favorite colors is Provincial. There's many other colors to choose from. There's cherry, white oak, Salem maple, and teak natural. Teak natural leaves a good contrast between the cuts and the surface of the wood, leaving the cuts a lot darker than these other stains. Now I use the same method. This stain is a little bit thicker than Ipswich Pine. Kind of halfway between Ipswich Pine and gel stain. So a brush is needed to apply the stain. After wiping the surface off, be sure and go back and get the excess out of the cuts with the brush. Without Ipswich Pine as a pre-stain, the Czar stain would be a much darker stain. Also, with Ipswich Pine, it helps the Czar stain to stain more evenly. Be sure and turn the project different angles so that you can make sure that every chip is stained properly. Now that's pretty. That's what sanding is all about. After staining the project with Czar stain, then you need to set the project aside for at least 24 hours to allow the stain to dry before varnishing it.
When the stain has dried, your project is now ready to varnish. I use a spray varnish called Deft Clear Wood Finish. First, I find a flat surface and I lay some newspaper down to protect the surface from the varnish. Next, I find some cardboard to set the project on because setting the project on the newspaper would make the newspaper stick to the project when the varnish dries. Although we talk about staining, sometimes we leave our projects unstained, especially when the basswood is with a hardwood such as walnut. Notice how the varnish enhances the color of the wood, making it darker and creating a shine. Allow about 30 minutes to 1 hour for the varnish to dry. After the varnish has dried, you'll notice that your project feels rough. To make the finish smooth, I use a brown paper sack. I cut out a small piece. When you rub your project with the paper sack, make sure there is no printing on the side of the paper sack that you rub against your project. Otherwise, the printing may rub off onto your project. While you are finishing your project, spray a few coats of varnish, rubbing your project with a paper sack in between each coat. Be sure to spray light coats because spraying too much may cause runs. Once your project has had a few coats of varnish, it is now complete. If you liked this video, please visit our website at higginsonwoodcreations.blogspot.com. If you're a carver and would like a catalog of our unfinished products, send us a request at tjhigginson@juno.com and leave us your name and address, or call any of these two numbers, but don't be surprised if we answer with Higginson Piano Service. We have everything from pencil holders to boxes to napkin holders to you name it. And don't forget to check out our website to see our finished products.